is tried until you find yourself crying all night long, walking the floor, asking God, when, God, when? When are you going to do it? When are you going to change it? When are you going to lift it? But look at somebody near you and tell them, but we're coming through this. We're coming through this. I know your hearts are broken, but squeeze your neighbor's hand and tell them they will heal your heart. Your heart will heal. For the greatest dimension of healing, I believe, is still established in the word of God. Paul told us in 1 Thessalonians chapter number 4, verse number 18, he said, comfort one another with these words. Look at your neighbor and tell them your healing is coming from the word of God. Yeah, we used to declare it, word brought me here. Look at your neighbor and tell them it is going to keep you in times like this. I'm not preaching, so when you get a little perplexed and that pain is a little overwhelming and the sensation becomes a little deep for you to bear, you got to do like David. And he cried unto the Lord, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that's higher. Look at your neighbor, tell him there's a higher place than this. There's a higher plane than this. There's a greater plateau than this. And so it is by your faith in the word of God that you will overcome. That Jehoshaphat, even when he heard of the battle that was ensuing, the Bible says that he saw God first. He called a nationwide fast, and he called a nationwide prayer, and he gathered the people together, and he sought the Lord. I'm so glad we had a woman of faith in our lives who understood the power of fasting and prayer and of seeking God first. You know how some of us do it. We don't necessarily ask God first, even though the Bible tells us in all thy ways acknowledge him and he shall direct thy path. We put our